some ginseng plants seems to have a genetic trait whereby they bloom earlier than ordinary and therefore produce seeds, ripe seed berries, earlier than the ordinary ginseng plant. I have found from experimentation that in the case of example of this plant, this is not even the 1st of August yet, and I already have a full umbel of ripe ginseng berries. If these seeds are kept separate in a bed of their own, they will produce, when they mature, early ginseng seeds also, and you can continue to propagate them from one generation to the next to produce early seeds, thereby the stratification process can be ignored. Seeds planted directly when their berries are ripe and produce new one-year seedling plants the first year after they're planted, eliminating the stratification process and the two-year wait from seeds to plants. And these seeds are protected, but the way I do it is a little drawstring bag put down over the berry pod to protect them from the wandering wild turkeys and other birds that loves to eat any kind of fruit. So these seeds can be collected anytime now and planted, and you can expect germination in the spring, this coming spring. These ginseng plants here are one-year-olds. The seed was planted last fall from early ripening seeds, and because of that, I planted them in here to further an experiment that I've got going, that if you plant the ginseng seeds that mature early, if you plant them the same year, they'll come up the following year instead of requiring 2 years for the seeds to germinate. So this is a proof positive that early ginseng seeds will germinate the first year, whereas if they were stratified along with the later ginseng seeds, they would die in stratification and you would lose them. So as an experiment, I have succeeded in growing them plants from seeds in 1 year instead of the normal two-year cycle that ginseng normally takes. It's a genetic trait that some plants have, some few plants. It's not normal. It's not the normal way of ginseng.